In this video, we're going to cover the high bar squat from the top down, complete tutorial A to Z. First up is bar placement. With high bar, we want to position the barbell at the top of the upper traps. This is the shelf position the bar will stay to allow a vertical squatting technique. Take a look at how I'm retracting and elevating my shoulders to allow the bar to rest on the meat of the upper traps. This sounds really simple, but make sure that the middle of the barbell is resting on the middle of the back. This comes down to a symmetrical hand placement on the bar and a proper setup. Hand placement on the bar is based on your shoulder mobility. The narrower the hand placement, the more shoulder mobility is needed. Ideally, you want to go as narrow as your shoulders allow to increase global body tension. Now that we're set up, let's talk about foot placement. This is based on your individual mobility in the hips and the ankles. The narrower the feet are placed, it's easier to keep the toes pointed straight ahead, and as the feet are taken wider apart, the feet will flare outward to match your hip orientation needs. Choose a stance which is comfortable for you and allows you to move the most weight safely. With the high bar squat, it's important to break first at the knees. This means when you lower down, the knees will move forward first, followed by the hips dropping. With a high bar squat, it's also necessary for the knees to move forward over the toes. This is a healthy, safe, and recommended movement for those without any pre-existing knee conditions. Let's look at setup and bracing. Every rep should be treated with importance to ingrain good habits for when you squat heavy. Unrack the bar, let it settle, and then take a few deliberate steps backwards and assume your squat stance. Take a deep breath in, hold the breath during your rep, and then exhale when you've passed the hard point on the way up. How you breathe in and brace is really important too. I want you to breathe deeply into the stomach and pull the ribs down before you descend into each rep. This will keep your spine safe and maximize the amount that you can lift. Looking at this technique applied from the front angle, my feet are shoulder width apart with a slight outward toeing to allow comfort at the hip. The elbows are being pulled towards the sides and under the bar to create a stable back position. I'm also keeping my knees over the middle of my toes on the way down and the way up. The knees out squat cue is great for resisting unwanted inward travel of the knees. With a high bar squat, we want the bar to travel as vertically as we can. Viewing a high bar squat from the side is a great way to assess your bar path. Taking a look at my bar path, it's quite vertical, but it definitely has room to improve by me working on my lower body mobility. Taking a look at the squat from behind, we want the hips to remain centered between the feet with equal force being produced from both legs. Make sure to keep both heels flat and then focus on actively clawing the toes into the ground. Complete contact with the ground is a small detail, but will definitely help you lift more weight. Let's cover a few key mistakes to avoid when you're doing your high bar squat. Firstly, don't let the knees cave inwards, as this increases your risk of knee injuries. Knees going in not only feels uncomfortable, but the technique looks pretty awkward too. Lastly, people are often told the chest up cue when they squat. This results in them not breathing into their stomach and then also flaring the ribs upwards. With this technique, you simply won't be as strong when you flare your ribs compared to the techniques that I taught earlier in this tutorial.